Thursday, and welcome to my session. I am getting ready to turn down my computer volume. So give me a sec. Oh shit. I'm a little slow this morning. I have to turn this around like that. Okay. How's that? Okay, hold on. Alrighty, so today I have a couple of things happening. Before we get started, I want to share with you something. You can see I'm very disorganized today. I guess that happens. All righty. Here we go. So, the first thing I do want to share is a new class I have coming up. This will be a 5-week journey through Zoom, and it will be about cosmic smash booking. And cosmic smash booking is a pretty fun activity. It's very deep. It's much deeper than most people realize. Sorry, I'm moving my camera around here. And the cool thing about it is you'll be making a cosmic smash book, which is very tactile, and we're going to be dealing with fairy time. Let me find it here. The project is called Fairy Time. Someone who has spent many years working with the fairy faith tradition of ancient Ireland and traveling to Ireland, and writing multiple books about the Irish fairy faith, I decided to do a 5-week live Zoom course on the fairy on fairy time, and we'll be exploring the deepness of our souls through the fairy motifs, and working with different aspects, creating different pages based on inquiries that we work with. So this 5-week journey is going to take us into fairyland, the fairy realm, really exploring deeply. Hello, kitty. Exploring deeply different facets of the fairy realm through cosmic smash booking, through soul inquiry. And so I'm going to invite you to join me for that and to get information on the time and the day of the week for it. All you have to do is go to my website, and my website is visionaryartist.com. visionaryartistpath.com. All run together, visionaryartistpath.com, and then go to my menu of classes and you'll see the Cosmic Smash booking. And come and join me. It's we'll have fun. 1 hour every week for 5 weeks. So I will see you there. That was my first announcement I wanted to make to you. All right. So I want to continue with this project here that I've been working on. I've got multiple videos already about this on YouTube. So I brought it over to Twitch Live because I think it provides more interaction. And so we've been creating, I'm taking you on a journey of making some very unique artsy little journals as you learn different mixed media techniques. And so on YouTube, I went over, I think I have 5 videos there that show you the first 5 steps of getting pages like this prepared and ready. And then I shared with you here Monday the creation of working with jelly plates and stencils. And so we're going to work with some of this today, combining them with these. So you can see I worked with sketch paper. I worked with rice paper. And I worked with wax paper. So these are all different feels. Okay. The other thing I want to work with is some collage pieces. So I'm going to just get out. I tend to go through magazines and pull out things. So I'm going to pull out a couple of these, couple of little pictures that we're going to work with. That's kind of cute. Well, that's cute. That's from a Trader Joe's magazine. A seahorse. That's kind of cool. Butterfly. Here's a better butterfly. Here's a cool octopus. Maybe I'll bring that in. Pig. Dove. I don't know if I'm going to use all these zebras. I like this crocodile in the rain. And bees and beehives. So here's a little kangaroo. So cute. Maybe this, I'm going to use animals in this. Well, like that. Like those horns, huh? Okay, I think I've got enough. That's cool, isn't it? Maybe I'll use that, even though it's not an animal. Okay, let's work with those and see what we want to use. So, I'm going to take, I'm going to be using gel. Just acrylic gel. And we're going to take some of these pages. I'll just work with one side to begin with. What side do I want to work with? Maybe I'll work with this side first. And I'm going to begin to layer them up. So I might take something like this, see, and put it down on the page in a couple of places. The other thing I want to get, see, here's leftovers from a different project. I could use pieces of this too, but I'm looking for something specific. All right, let's pull out this. I want to have some text. So, I don't want to have all those bubbles in there. So I'm gonna let this dry, this page dry, because I've now added elements to it. Mm-hmm. just pulling out a few things I might use on this page. This is from a previous. All right, I'm going to put this aside. tearing paper. So when you tear it towards you, okay, you get the color. You don't get the white line. Okay, so that's important to know. So if I wanted my music to have white line all over it, I would tear the white part toward me. I'll demonstrate that again, because it really is something you should know. But if you don't know that, that's an important tip for doing collage work with pieces that you rip out instead of fussy cut. Okay, so I'll take this piece right here. So again, when I tear it toward me, it's not going to give me any white edge. Okay, it doesn't give any white edge. If I want a white edge, then let's say I want a white edge, then whatever I want as the white edge, I want to make sure that it's being torn against. You can't see it really well on this because this is white already. Here, I'll do it right here. You ready? Again, it doesn't do it really well on that either. Okay, well, sorry. Okay, I think this one's done too. So let me go back to the first one and see if it's dry enough to do the background. Let's wipe this up because it's kind of sticky. I'm going to just shoot these with the blow dryer real quick. Okay. Here's the first one we started with. Really like him. I think I'm liking this for such a drastic contrast. And then I could bring in this little guy, see? I'm telling you, Trader Joe's mailer or catalog has some really cool little fun clip art. Okay, so this one has both sides done. See that? So I'm gonna let this really dry. So see, I do a little planning before I lay down, just for the size of the pieces. Oops, I might have put my head in the... I really like that number 11 right there. That's the reason why I stripped it like that. 11, master number. I so clearly love. See, look at that. I so clearly love. What is this from? Oh, it's a Jane Austen book. No, maybe not. Anyways, it doesn't matter. Now that side's done. You can see how different these all are. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Little Joey. Seahorse. All right. Now we have one left to do. Here's the music side. Let's see. Music is right. Okay. I love this one. I love rice paper. It's just such a cool texture. If you've never worked with rice paper, splurge. It's not that expensive, and you get a whole pack of it. All right, let's see what we're gonna put on this one. This one I'm gonna fussy cut. This will be see, some of these are going to get cut right in half, but yeah, it'll make the books interesting. All right, that one's done. And that's the other side. Okay, give me a sec. Right, so here we are, and I'm gonna get this in water to start the cleaning process on it. All right, so these will have to dry really good overnight, so I won't work with them. I'll work with them on next Monday. So next Monday, we'll be compiling things and beginning to see an actual art journal emerge. But they do have to really, really, really dry. So at this point, I'm going to call it a day and encourage you, if you have not watched the first five steps of creating the boards here, you'll find them on my YouTube channel. So remember, you can go to my website, Visionary Artist Path, and at the Visionary Artist Path you will find at the bottom of the page a link to my YouTube channel, and have fun with them there. And if you can't find it, just pop me a note in the chat next Monday. And in the meantime, you can be working on the jelly plate and getting together collage materials, and then you can kind of do it backwards a little bit. All right, so we're gonna let these eight pages dry really nicely. And I wanna show you something. I didn't use, and you'll probably not even know that, but I did not use any of the, well, I used one. I did not use three of the sketch paper that I did on Monday, because these are going to be standalone pages. So mostly today I used one of them as collage material, but mostly I used the rice papers, right? And I used the wax paper, and then of course collage elements. So remember that some of the pages I have you make on Monday with the jelly prints are going to be used as actual pages in the art journal. So that's something to just remember. I will never use rice paper or wax paper as, well, maybe the wax paper, but not the rice paper. It rips too easily. So for Monday, you're gonna wanna have maybe three of these, two or three of your sketch paper. Maybe one wax paper, whatever is left over of it. Like this one, I didn't use at all. That's okay. Your eight double-sided, right? And we're gonna do a little bit more embellishment on these pages, and then we will begin to put it all together, all right? Thanks for joining me for Thursday Twitch I will see you for my fairy time next week. So be sure you register and join me. It's a 5-week experience and we'll be live in Zoom together. And no need to be shy. I don't know you. So it'll be a good experience. And have fun creating. Bye, bye, bye. All right, let me get this going to close. End. Oops.